We will now start our afternoon session with our first speaker, Architect Sujata Shakya. Architect Sujata Shakya has completed her bachelor's in architecture from Institute of Engineering, Pulchok campus in 2012, and MSc in construction management in 2019 from the same institute. As a researcher for certification of green building and leadership in energy and environment design, and urban density study for low-rise, high-density settlement in Kathmandu Valley. She worked as a team facilitator in reconstruction of school buildings in more than 5 districts after devastating Gorkha earthquake of Nepal. For the last 1 year, her involvement was in construction of Gautam Buddha International Airport, one of the national pride projects of Nepal, in capacity of site architect. Besides that, she has also published an article in Journal of Advanced Research in Construction and Urban Architecture titled Risk Assessment in Construction of Gautam Buddha International Airport. Recently, she is leading the team of the Himalayan Institute of Alternative Ladakh in design and construction of university using alternative materials and technologies. She has experience of working with Kathmandu Valley Preservation Trust in preservation of around 200 years of old building in Bhaktapur. As her journey starts working with alternative technology, she has destined to be an entrepreneur architect for local technology with the motto, earth building for earth jungle instead of concrete building for concrete jungle. She has a pledge that her small contribution would lead and promote the earth building construction that may give the major positive impact to reduce the increasing effects of climate change as a ripple effect. Ladies and gentlemen, Architect Sujata Shakya.
Thank you so much. Honorable chairperson, distinguished guest, and my dear friends, good afternoon, namaste from the Himalayan state of Nepal. First of all, I would like to thank the Institute of Architects Pakistan for giving me an opportunity to represent my country in this IAPEX conference 2020. I would also like to thank and express my gratitude for selecting me as a speaker of design narrative story of a spatial story of an innovative campus SECMOL. SECMOL, Students Educational and Cultural Movements of Ladakh, is an alternative school situated 17 kilometers away of Leh, which is the capital of Ladakh, India. SECMOL was founded in 1988 by a group of Ladakhi college students. For many years, SECMOL worked on reforming the government school system. So SECMOL campus organically grew into an eco-village where staff, students, and volunteers live, work, and learn together. It's not a conventional school, but a place to pursue social, practical, and environmental skills, values, and knowledge. The whole campus is solar power, solar heated, and also it's built by the students. So how I came across the ideas of exploring this innovative campus is, I happened to visit this school when me and my friend were invited from Nepal to attend Sun and Earth Festival in 2016. In these festivals, architects, artists, engineers, environmentalists, and all around the world gather to share the experiences of earth constructions and passive solar design. So SECMOL is located in such a geographical terrain which is similar to that of trans-Himalayan regions of Nepal, such as Manang and Mustang. So belonging to the similar geographical context, what attracted me by this school is the learning that the development model of such challenging climates ought to be contextual innovations rather than random imitations of urban technology. So this is the video. I capture some significant features of spatial quality of SECMOL rather than a thorough story of the whole campus. So this is the story of the campus with zero energy consumption, even in extremities of the winters, where the temperature falls into minus 35 degrees Celsius. So isn't this the amazing story? Now let's watch the video. Architecture in modern day is almost synonymous to the display of prosperity and human achievement. Integration of modern technology to meet need of urban human reflects its form, function and expression of fastly changing modern world. But what about the basic function of architecture as a form desired to give shelter? A function to serve age-old culture that evolved as a result to live with ecology. Is it still relevant? With the crisis that the humanity is facing, our species is seeking for both physical and spiritual balance with its surrounding. Will this limit the creativity of human civilization? Will architecture limit itself to just a survival value? Or survival itself is willing to become the source of thriving? The harsh climatic context of Himalayan and trans-Himalayan regions presents challenges to living for ages. For example, temperature falling up to minus 20 degrees Celsius, limited food and water supplies, migration of youth to comfortable city centers, and of course the radical solution presented by modernity. No, there are alternative ways popping out at nooks and corners of this region through innovations of unconventional architects. For example, Anna Fenestra in Afghanistan, Hemendra Bohra in Nepal, and Sonam Wangchuk in India are few to name. These are the places where thriving is not different from surviving. As a bit of this ever-growing innovative chain, Sekpol presents itself as a pole. The history was not so easy. No harshness ever left to demoralize its people physically and systematically. In order to combat this, students gather for educational and cultural improvement for themselves. Along with widespread awareness of contextual education, they started from a shelter for learning. With improvised age-old local technology of Adobe and Ram Earth emerging itself from the soil of the cold desert, finally giving form to a passively heated building that encloses innovative learning environment within. The buildings from outside seem to grow from the earth herself like trees. A need of warmth for survival manifesting more than survival itself.
Hello, Zule. Welcome to Sekmol campus. Wow. What is this? Hello, Julie.
I'm Ishi. I'm a student here.
Okay. So what is this all about?
These are monies modified to give information about the whole campus.
Okay, it's so creative.
As you can see from the pics, these are from some of the activities that we do here at the campus. And this is some basic information about the building.
Okay.
Yes.
So I'm so much curious about Sekmol. Can you tour me around this campus?
Sure, I will. This is our bathroom.
This looks like greenhouse, huh?
This is, yeah.
Wait, does this remain closed also in summer?
No, it is a seasonal attached greenhouse. We cover it only in winter. In summer, we do not need it. It is warm enough.
Okay.
Architecture is not just a passive service given for its occupants in Sekmol. This is a part of active community participation and part of learning itself.
This is our traditional toilet.
Looks like two-story.
Yes, in the lower part we collect the waste and it is going to be used as manure latter. But after 2 years.
Managing the compost from dry toilet is one of the activities integrated in the built environment itself. Managing the building services engages the students to be more interactive within the building itself.
Wow, this is how you manage the waste.
Yes.
Students will follow this.
Yes, yes, of course.
It seems like so many chambers here.
Yes, we have 11 different chambers in total.
Okay.
And 4 different types of waste. And first of all, we try to reduce the waste and then we reuse it and then we try to recycle it.
Okay, so
architecture itself asks for management of the waste.
Okay. It looks like a secret way, huh? Where are we leading to?
You will get to see.
Approaches with curiosity are parts of architecture in Sekmol.
It looks like locally made door clamp.
Yes, it is an automatic door clamp. We made it with a simple principle of gravity, as you can see. As we open it, it goes up, and as I release it, it will go down.
Okay.
So it works like this.
Nice.
Such small innovative details show architecture does not have to wait market for all its services. And these are stuff people spend their time watching amazingly.
This look interesting. I think there is wall inside of the glass.
Mm-hmm. Yes, this is called dome wall and we have blackened this southern part. As you can see from the side, see this is blackened. So yeah. This acts as a heat bank for the hall.
Passive solar design is a strict norm to all the old and new buildings.
There are many more interesting things to show you.
Okay, let's go. Wow, it's interesting, huh? It looks like sacred space to live in.
Yes, this is car house. It was made by one of the former students of the campus. And we come here and study and also we do stargazing in the night time.
Okay, it's nice.
Modern learning modality recognizes such introspective space as cave, where there are opportunities for introspective learning. The main learning area encourages collaborative learning. The sunkenness of the classroom not only prevents heat loss from the room, but also provides level difference for more interesting space. This exhibition cum corridor gives almost impression of an enclosed street. This is also the source of the light for the classroom. Daylight is the most beautiful and elegant way to give form to space. And manifestations of such small human attentions, of course, doesn't need high-tech resource. Modern learning setup is not apart from the regional vocabulary in Sekmol, but it is a part of it. These construction vocabularies are still used but modified to meet the modern demand. Neither old design vocabularies are left over. Cultural interaction is a routine in Sekmol. The community working in kitchen is the learning from collective living of Ladakh. And all these traditional values still serve modern purpose. They have rather become a source of modern wisdom. The learning of sustainable living is what Sekmol has to present to rest of the world. Experts from different countries, such as France, Germany, Nepal, etc., gather to have Sun and Earth Festival. People around the world share their experiences in art, architecture, and construction.
For the vertical surface, south-facing, for January we use 3,000 actually.
And Sekmol has now presented itself as a source of passive solar education, sharing its experience to rest of the world. But the journey doesn't end here. Few kilometers away from Sekmol, this cold desert is slowly being converted into a university. Sekmol has finally become seed for this ambitious university of the Himalayas, the Himalayan Institute of Alternatives, Ladakh. Elegant application of simple scientific laws has become the legacy transferred from Sekmol. And the learning of the last 30 years is giving shape to a model university with oath of building modern sustainable communities in Trans-Himalayas. When God was creating the universe, there were some leftovers. Architects can only use such leftovers to create newer things, Professor Sudarshan Raj Tiwari. We all architects from Nepal have a place. Let's join our hands together for initiation and promotion of sustainable architecture for the Himalayan regions with the motto, Earth building for earth jungle instead of concrete building for concrete jungle.
Thank you so much. In addition to this video, I would like to say that it's the campus of doers with based on the principles of 3H, that means head, heart, and hand, rather than our conventional system of 3R, that is reading, writing, and arithmetic. So at last, but not the least, I would like to say that Sekmol presents itself as a model campus with consolidations of contextual art, architecture, and culture. Thank you.
Thank you, Sujata, for sharing the amazing story. Our next speaker.